Good tidings, my friends. It's that time of year, the season of giving and holiday cheer. The fireplace is crackling, fake snow is in the air. The tippy tree's out, but its branches are bare. That simply won't do, so please help me adorn it. If you make something special, you just might be rewarded. With a brand new 3D printer, what? Cool. That's right, it's finally time for another competition, and thanks to the generosity of Sovol 3D, I get to give away a brand new Sovol SV06 printer and their dual filament dryer. The objective is simple. Help me make some new ornaments for the Tippi Tipmas Tree, and I'll choose my favorite two to win those two prizes. Maybe you remember the cool Tippi Tree fruit design I came up with a little system that lets you snap the stems into place. And that's the same system we're gonna be using for making these ornaments. If that sounds a little daunting, don't worry, because I've actually developed a special tool to help you turn all kinds of different models into Tippi ornaments using all kinds of different software. And in this video, well, we're gonna be learning something, of course. I'll show you several different ways to make your own ornaments in Tinkercad, Fusion 360, and beyond. So have no fear, I'll get through the rules throughout this video and post all the information in the description. But for now, why don't we go ahead and see what it takes to make some of these ornaments. For the first method, I'm gonna show you how we make one of these ornaments in Tinkercad, since that's a super accessible modeling program that a lot of you might already be familiar with. It's totally free, and that means you can definitely do it. First of all, we need the Tippi Tree Ornament Tool. You can download that following the link in this video's description at my mini factory, and then we can head to tinkercad.com. This runs right out of our web browser, which is awesome, so let's create a new 3D design. That will load up the workspace, and we can design our ornament first, but I'm gonna import the ornament tool right away. Make sure the units are set to millimeters and leave the rest as is. Then click import, and after a few seconds, that tool should pop into our workspace. Next, we'll select the model and use this little arrow to drag it down minus 40 millimeters so the circular surface lines up with the work plane, like so. Great, now we just need an ornament. For this demo, I'm just gonna use this basic dice shape, drag that into our project, and I can hold shift while dragging one of these corners to scale it up uniformly to 27 millimeters so it encapsulates the top of the ornament tool. Hold shift to select both shapes, and then we'll use this align tool. With that, we can click these two dots to center the shapes in the X and Y directions. Now that the tool is properly lined up with the dice ornament, I'll just select the ornament tool and go over here to change it from a solid to a hole, so we can subtract it from the dice. To apply that, once again, we'll hold shift and click to select both parts, and then select this group option. And just like that, we've created the negative space that lets us connect the stem to this ornament. We'll click export, choose the STL option, and save the file. That's all there is to it, so time to print. While you're not required to have a 3D printer to enter this contest, it is useful to make sure your design works as intended. Plus, getting a nice photo to present your piece can go a long way. For example, here I did a bunch of filament swaps using Polyterra PLA on my SV01 Pro to make this sweet retro rainbow pattern. Once that's done, I'll pop in the stem to complete our first ornament. There you have it. Pretty simple, right? But if you're like me, you might actually be more comfortable in Fusion 360. And since I designed the tool in Fusion, I can actually give you the link to the tool itself, and it'll be really nice and easy to build your ornament around that. I won't go too in-depth here, since this option is for those of you who already know your way around Fusion 360. I designed my shape inspired by the popular chromatic vases I shared 5 years ago. All you've got to know is that you can use the combine tool to subtract the stem part from the ornament. And once again, we're left with a part that's compatible with the Tippi stem. I printed this one on the SV06 using Matterhacker's Quantum PLA to get an awesome two-color gradient. And while I've only just started printing with the SV06, I'm quite impressed with it. If I were you, I'd be pretty excited about the chance to win one. Here's another chromatic ornament printed with the blue-yellow Quantum PLA, and I think both of these are pretty stunning. Okay, this next method is gonna show you how you can kind of turn any model into an ornament, although I'm gonna go pretty extra, and I'm gonna use this pillow and actually 3D scan it to turn it into that little tiny ornament down there. Here's one of my latest awesome tools, the 𝐒𝐡𝐩𝐸𝐸𝐲 handheld 3D scanner by Shining3D. And in order to get a full scan of this pillow, I decided to hang it up so I could get this drooping form and to scan every angle without changing its shape. That actually ended up being a really awesome method of 3D scanning, so it won't be the last time I do it like this. I was also very impressed with the ease of use and the amount of detail picked up by the 𝐒𝐡𝐩𝐸𝐲 scanner. I won't go into much for this video, but expect more about it on this channel in the near future. Today, the main point of this is to show how we can use Microsoft 3D Builder to turn just about any mesh into an ornament. So here, I've opened the Tippi Tree Ornament Tool in 3D Builder, and after importing that, we can click Insert and Add to bring the pillow scan into the same scene by going to Load Object and finding that pillow STL. When we bring that in, 3D Builder has this handy feature that will repair the model with one click to make sure it's completely solid and watertight. This is useful for all sorts of meshes, but especially 3D scans, which often have holes or other broken surfaces. Once that's done, we can reorient and scale our scan. If there's a stable surface, this settle tool can work wonders. But for this lumpy pillow, it didn't really help, so I just had to do it by eye. This is also scanned at 1:1 scale, so I need to shrink it way down. And I actually just brought in the original Barry model for reference. Another thing I really like about 3D Builder is the X-ray view when an object isn't selected. That helped me line up the tool with the pillow, and once I had it positioned in a way that would eliminate any steep overhangs and ensure a clean print, I selected just the ornament tool and then used Subtract to cut it away from the 3D scan. That gives us a nice flat surface to print from, and we can also use that settle tool. Then we can save our new ornament as an STL file. Once again, I'm printing this on the SV01 Pro using Matterhacker's Quantum PLA. I can't help myself, it just makes prints look so cool, especially when there's lots of tiny details like this. I thought that one was pretty fun, and I love seeing the little tiny texture of that big pillow on this tiny little ornament. Of course, I know most of you don't have access to a fancy 3D scanner like that, but you can actually go online to sites like Thingiverse and find files that are available for Creative Commons licensing. For example, I found this really cool 3D scan of a pine cone by Scobo. And as long as I give them credit, I have permission to use that really awesome scan to make a Tippi pine cone. There you go, yet another way to make some really cool ornaments. Just make sure if you are using someone else's model that you respect the license that they're using to distribute it. So for example, with that pine cone, it's Creative Commons with attribution. Thank you, Scobo. I'll also give credit on the actual page when I submit that model. And yeah, the 3D printing and 3D modeling community can be pretty generous. So I'm sure there's a lot of really cool models out there with similar licenses that you can use and slightly modify to make some awesome Tippi ornaments. So here are all the different fruits and ornaments I've come up with so far. It's a good variety, but with the collective creativity of this community, I know this year's Tippmas tree is gonna be extra special. And because I want to display as many of your ornaments as I can manage, I've made this new Tippi Tree connector piece that will help me make a bigger tree that's somewhat stable. But it is still a Tippi Tree, so wish me luck. So, are you up for the challenge? Hopefully, because there's a free 3D printer and a dual filament dryer on the line here. So hopefully that's encouragement, plus just being able to make some awesome ornaments that I'll use to adorn the Tippi Tipmas tree. So let's quickly run over the rules one more time. First of all, you've got to use that Tippi Tree tool that makes the ornament compatible with the standard Tippi fruit stem. Your model has to be printable with a single extruder printer. Multiple parts and filament swaps are okay, but no multi-material printing. Unless you want to add that as an optional thing, but I'm going to be judging it as something you can print with a single extruder. The model also has to print without support material. You got to think about it. If hundreds of people are going to be printing this awesome ornament, you don't want all that support material adding up and being a bunch of wasted plastic. So that's a constraint that's always a nice challenge to force yourself to stick to. Next, you got to make sure to leave room for other ornaments on the tree. So the maximum dimensions are 42 by 42 millimeters wide. The length isn't strictly defined, but just be reasonable. And you know, the standard berry is 28 millimeters by 28 millimeters. So generally aim closer to that unless your idea demands something slightly larger. Once you're happy with your model, you can submit it to My Mini Factory as a remix of the Tippi Ornament Tool. You can submit as many entries as you want. Just submit them individually and realize that I'm judging them one by one. So having a whole bunch doesn't necessarily help you. You're better off making something really cool. Last of all, this isn't the actual Tippi Tipmas tree that we'll be putting the ornaments on. Hopefully I'll get enough submissions to make something a bit bigger, but this is the general format. So realize that the berries are gonna be hanging in this orientation with the stems going front to back. So depending on your design, you might need to take that into consideration. I'm super excited to see what you all come up with. So the competition starts now and it ends on December 19th at midnight Pacific Standard Time. Make sure you submit them before then so they're eligible to win. And of course, so I have time to print them before revealing the grand Tippmas tree on December 25th. That's pretty much all there is to it. Like I said, I'm gonna be the sole judge here, picking my two favorite designs. Top design will get the Sovol SV06, and second place will get the dual filament dryer, also by Sovol 3D. And big thanks to Sovol, they're providing these prizes for free, and they're even covering custom fees, so it's for anyone around the world. Go ahead, get to it, make some awesome ornaments, and let's make the most Tippi Tipmas tree there's ever been. Like I said, I'll put all the important information in the video description. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments or in the Make Anything Discord server. And yeah, get making. Make some cool ornaments, let's go. Oh, I almost forgot. Stay inspired.